We're at Fort Ticonderoga in Ticonderoga, New York. We're at the Fort Ticonderoga Education Center, which is housed in one of the original buildings, which is now a very modern building. It contains many artifacts from the time period and directly related to this fort. It's a picture of Henry Knox. Dragging the cannon from the here to New York, or Boston, sorry, Boston. Four-pounder cannon recovered from the Penobscot River in Maine. Six-pounder cannon. Covered in 1853. These are the guns of Ticonderoga. The numbers and types listed on this wall. When such census were taken, inventory I should say, not census. Okay, now we're going into artillery by the 18th century. This is a light 3-pound field piece forged by Jan and Peter Verbruggen, who were Dutch. Dutch founders, foundry casting masters. This is a more or less a howitzer. It's a really intricate design. Mortar, possibly French, don't know. Interesting. So this is French and it. By the markings on it. King's crown, the Sun King, which Louis XIV considered himself. I believe all the French kings declared themselves to be that. Is one of fewer than 10 American mark brass artillery pieces in existence from the Revolution. Well, that's interesting. It wasn't necessarily British. And crane stairs. This is a painting from 1748 showing the French regiment encamped during the final campaigns of the War of Austrian Succession in Provence. This will just give you an idea of life in camp for French army. These are various paintings of artillerymen. I'm going to go in here. Half. is the fragment of a 13-inch mortar. Equipment needed for cannons, some of the various shot and shell, double-headed shot. This would have exited the cannon and spun around. Anti-personnel also used to tear up ship masts. Here we have various. This is a ball gauge measurer. Another one. Big the balls were before you stuck them in the cannon. Couldn't get them out. And these are rules and levels in sight, which is how they sighted the cannon back in those days. Powder barrel hoop. This is really neat. This shows the construction of a carriage, gun carriage wheel. The drawing obviously is of the whole wheel, but these are real artifacts from the wheels. It's really fascinating. Incredibly fascinating. Wood would have been the spokes and iron would have held that wood together tightly. Scale model of a 24-pound gun carriage. French. This 8-pound cannon is the only piece of artillery found at Fort Ticonderoga, which is very fascinating. Very interesting. Here's a mortar. Looks like it's in English. Oh yes, it says it's in English. These pictures show the foundry and the method for making the guns. This is a famous gun founder from the 18th century, French. And this That's going to do it for this exhibit area. This is a very neat exhibit for its time frame. We're going to go back up and explore the rest of the fort some more. Okay.